They always tell us that if you work really hard in your life, you'll have those golden years to enjoy. But is that really true? Stay tuned for my not-so-humble opinion on the matter coming at you once again on Charles Hurst Reinvention. I can't tell you how many times I've seen people working huge amounts of hours at jobs they really don't like through their 20s all the way to their 60s on the reasoning that they're going to do what they want to do once they reach 65. Their golden years, so to speak. The idea is you sacrifice your entire youth, your 20s, 30s, 40s, 50s, in an effort to be a good company employee at something you probably don't really enjoy that much, in which you'll be rewarded with a payoff, which will give you your freedom to do as you please between the ages of 65 and 100 at best. And I have to tell you, this is the wrong philosophy to carry in your life. In my sample survey to prove I'm correct, all the residents I used to work with in the nursing homes during my early days of physical therapy who followed exactly that plan. Now first, I'm not saying you should be carefree and stupid about life. Well, maybe carefree, but not stupid. You don't want to be completely irresponsible, not have a trade, skill, degree, or something where you can accumulate assets for the future. You definitely have to do that. I did a video once on a guy I had met in my travels who was homeless by choice, but stated he was free. I contend he wasn't free at all. Having $2 in your pocket with a hungry stomach while living underneath a bridge is not freedom. But there are many choices and proper planning that you can make. The choices that most of society doesn't make, where you can invest and save quite a bit so you're not a slave as a company man or woman. But the one thing I found while talking to all these elderly in those years that I did work in the nursing homes is that they weren't quite as free as they thought once they turned 65. Most of them spent their entire lives working and paying bills, and the prize at the end of the journey, it wasn't nearly as shiny as advertised. First of all, there's no guarantee you're gonna make 65 anyway. I had a friend who was like a brother who passed away from cancer at the age of 49, and I am now at the age where I can peruse through social media and have discovered that several of my classmates from high school are already deceased. Being a workaholic your whole young adult life and even middle adult life because you're banking on that freedom at 65 or 67 is really playing a game of roulette. But let's assume you are going to live to be 85. You're not going to be as physically able as you were in your 20s. I have known 65-year-olds who have completed the Pacific Crest Trail, a through hike that starts at the border of Mexico and ends at Canada. But I also know a lot of 65-year-olds who couldn't even begin to start that hike because their knees, hips, and ankles are already shot. Some of them already have artificial joint replacements by that age. You're not going to roam the mountains of Scotland like you would as a kid. And I can tell you, you're not going to have the energy to do all those things that you could in your youth. At 60 years old, just going to the Vatican and taking the 4-hour walk which eventually ends at the Sistine Chapel will probably do it for you for the day. For I can tell you, even at the age of 54, there is an ever-present temptation to just lie down and give it all up. I make myself go and see places, but a 2-hour walk in 90-degree heat in Mazatlan, Mexico, usually wipes me out not only for that day, but for the next one as well. And I've had many patients who were financially very well off, but had worked so much during their career lives that they didn't take care of themselves. And now their bodies can't even tolerate really wandering around Rome for a day. And instead of becoming a CFO, maybe they should have taken a job as a consultant so they could take off 4 months to wander Rome in their youth. But you take away the physical limitations if you are still alive after 65, there's another reason you don't want to wait for those almighty golden years before you start doing what you really want to do. It's because the obligations in life that you think are going to go away aren't. And neither are all the roadblocks that life throws in front of you. Most of you are going to have children, which are going to give you grandchildren. And many times your children are going to try to obligate you through the ancient ancestral booming voice known as family. One of your kids gets divorced, and suddenly they think your role is now to be the professional babysitter while they work. Or somebody's emotionally in trouble, or somebody needs help. and they can't make it without yours. And I've seen this repeatedly in my patient population as well, because most people don't have the heart to say no. And there's the other aspect of the ever-changing economic situation, which may completely thwart your plans for the future. How about this wonderful thing known as inflation? We already can't exist off Social Security alone in this country, but let's say you have a significant nest egg from your savings during your working days. And let's say its buying power gets cut in half because of our screwed up politicians. It happened in the 1970s and it's happening now. What you thought was gonna last you out, if you do make it to 90 or 100 years old, suddenly isn't. And now you suddenly see yourself as having to have a part-time job to supplement your Social Security and investments. You know, the ones you worked like a demon for decades because you thought it was gonna purchase your freedom. And now you realize that the freedom was actually just a brief furlough. And again, I cannot reiterate more how many elderly I've known in my own career, how many sacrificed their entire lives banking on those golden years to find out in the end that that gold was actually a lesser metal. And then they're sitting at the end of their lives with this gigantic plate of regret because they were told by society in the end they would get to do what they wanted and they didn't get that at all. Yes, I'm telling you to be good at your trade. As a matter of fact, I'm telling you to be as good at it as you possibly can. I'm telling you to set yourself up where at least you can have money coming in to invest, which will build wealth over time. And I'm telling you, you're gonna have to put in years of consistency at your craft. But I'm also telling you not to sacrifice your existence for a company for some future hope decades later of freedom. You work a reasonable amount of hours and you spend the rest of your time living life, because you don't know when the day's gonna come when that will no longer be an option. I'm Charles Hurst, author of Reinvention of Self, How to Change Your Life and Being Forever. That and other works are found on Amazon. See the link in the video description below. I don't ask for donations. If you buy one of my books for a couple bucks, then you'll get something of great value in return. But that is the capitalistic way. If you're ready to join our tribe of excellence, hit that subscribe, tap the like, and smash the bell, and I will see you at the next sunrise.